Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. My name is Byron and I'm a traffic engineer living in the US. On this channel, I like to talk about many topics, especially transportation. If you've been out on the roads lately, you may have been seeing more of these. What are they? We call them rectangular rapid flashing beacons, or RRFBs. They are one of the many things traffic engineers can implement to enhance a pedestrian crossing. Today, I'd like to talk about a story of when, one time, engineers were told by the US government that they were not allowed to install these devices. But the story has a good ending. So to start us off, an RRFB is what we call a traffic control device. In general, things like signs, markings, and traffic signals which regulate the flow of traffic can be considered traffic control devices. As traffic engineers, we use the Manual of Uniform Traffic Control Devices, or MUTCD, as a standard to follow for all traffic control devices. This federal manual has requirements for everything you can imagine, from the size of the traffic signals to even the color of the traffic signs. For us to install a traffic control device, it needs to conform to the standards set by the MUTCD. A traffic device that does not follow its manual should not be used. The RRFB is a relatively new device, and it started emerging in the early 2000s. There was one problem. It did not comply to the MUTCD. So what happens when a new device like the RRFB gets interest for installation? This can be a problem since it can be many years since the last time the MUTCD was updated. Sometimes a decade or more can go by with the manual not being updated. A fairly long process needs to be followed in order to approve a new device for the MUTCD. After applying, experiments and studies must show success. Next, an amendment process with comments and review period would be needed before the changes are officially published. But there's another way. Turns out the Federal Highway Administration can issue what they call interim approvals. An interim approval grants permission to install a new traffic control device that's not allowed under the current MUTCD, with the assumption that it will be added and updated in a future edition. So how did the rectangular rapid flashing beacons, or RRFBs, receive interim approval? Back in 2008, promising research showed RRFBs significantly increased yielding compliance for cars when required to yield to pedestrians compared to the normal round yellow flashing beacons. This meant cars were more likely to stop for pedestrian if RRFBs were used. In some cases, the times a car would stop for pedestrian increased from under 20% to as high as 80% or even close to 100% at some crossings. Because of this, the RRFB received interim approval on July 16th, 2008. This was great news. Engineers were now allowed to install RRFBs. But many years later, as the RRFBs became more common, many engineers did not know of the surprise that was to come. In December 2017, almost a decade after the initial interim approval, the Federal Highway Administration issued a termination of the interim approval. This came as a shock and meant that we couldn't install RRFBs anymore. At the time, all RRFBs that were already installed could operate until its useful life, but no installations or replacements were allowed. There was definitely a lot of confusion on this reversal. Imagine if you're an engineer and you already ordered them, or maybe you got a grant to install them. What should you do if you knew the alternatives were not going to be as effective? Should you substitute less effective devices? Or should you wait and maybe it all gets sorted out? So what happened to cause the Federal Highway Administration to rescind their previous interim approval? Sometime around 2017, vendors and manufacturers of traffic control devices started receiving copyright infringement notices from Rick Jones, the inventor of the RRFB. This caused a problem because no device in the MUTCD can be under a patent. There are many reasons why the MUTCD cannot have a patented product. The first is the federal government is prohibited to endorse a patented product, individual, or company. Second, allowing a patent device will force the government to allow competing devices that are different but similar to the patented device. Imagine if you had to remember 8 different kinds of stop signs. Because of this patent, Federal Highway Administration was forced to rescind the previous interim approval. A couple months after, Rick Jones sold his patents to Carmona Technologies Corporation, a manufacturer of traffic and safety products. Carmona then disclaimed the patents, allowing other manufacturers to produce RRFBs again without fear of copyright infringement. Soon after, the Federal Highway Administration issued a new interim approval, IA-21, for the RRFB in March of 2018, allowing installation of them once again. So if you're driving on the road or using a crosswalk with a rectangular rapid flashing beacon, remember that we once temporarily lost permission to use them. I, for one, am thankful that they are around and how the parties got together and solved the issues at the time. It goes to show that sometimes safety triumphs over profit. And that's the story of how we briefly lost permission to use rectangular rapid flashing beacons in the US and got it back. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you'd like to see more content like this in the future. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.